my mask be a bit more clear for a few minutes. It's a good coincidence that we are now talking here and not at the enhanced surveillance where we usually meet with the other people that are in this panel. Greece in the next few years faces a unique challenge. We have to recover from a recession caused by the pandemic and the blows that it gives to our economy, and at the same time cover the huge investment gap created by the 10-year Greek economic crisis and the mistakes of past policies. Our economic policy has thus to face a double challenge. We have to counter the consequences of COVID-19 in a big number of sectors. Almost half of the economy is in trouble, while the other half is doing quite well. This is interesting. And at the same time, at the public finances, where we try to have a very responsible attitude, but still it's a challenge for the public finances. And at the same time, tackle the past problems, the overtaxation and the very high non-wage cost of labor, which are basic problems for the Greek economy, plus the bureaucracy that is burdening the suffocating businesses, and also, and this is very important, the fact that a big part of our economy still today is in the black sector. So it uses tax evasion and pension contributions evasion, black labor, to as a competitive advantage instead of innovation, instead of economies of scale and quality. So we have to, and this is done partly because of tradition or the way businesses are built, some businesses are built, but also because of over-taxation and very high pension contribution costs. So what we are trying to do, and we are trying to do it also as a way to recovery and to reach gain growth, is to change the productive model from a more introvert economy based on where a big part of it or significant part of it uses as a competitive advantage the black economy, to an extrovert economy that looks outside and tries to compete internationally. And at that transition, it's very important to lower taxes and non-pension labor costs. This change of economic model is essentially a big part of our government program, together with the digital transformation of the public sector and the increase of effectiveness of the public sector, and we are forced to move towards this direction a lot faster than we had initially planned, because we need to be a lot more efficient and more effective in comparison to any other past Greek government because of the circumstances. Also, this is a huge challenge because of the Recovery and Resilience Fund, the funds connected with the next generation. Now, I will not go, as I have planned, to how this fund works. I will just say that the basic difference of this fund compared to the previous or the existing European programs is that it is based on targets and milestones rather than reforms as its in its core and the cost of reforms. Up till now, the European programs were loosely attached to the reforms happening in the country, and the idea of paying the cost of reforms has not yet been realized essentially in European programs. This is a big change. The second big change in this program is that the time is extremely limited. We are talking about 5.5 years between the start of the program and the end, the final end, the last payment, the last milestone or target that we have to achieve. It's sometime in the middle of 2026, while the program will start at the beginning of 2021. And this is double the, it needs double the speed compared to other European programs. For example, for ESPA, there were 10 years, almost 10 years between the initial planning and the final payment. Now it's 5. And when you take into consideration that in Greece, compared to the planned execution of projects, we have on average 23 months that we are late in historically in the procurement process, and then another 28 months that we are late historically in the execution process. Essentially, this is the these 23 and 28 months, if you add them, are the whole time of the program. So we have to essentially make a revolution in terms of how fast and how effectively we manage things here in Greece to make this program work. And this revolution to be made needs a big change in attitudes, not only within a government, this government or whatever the Greek people decide in the next 4 or 5 years, because we would have also in this space an election sometime, but also in the whole of the Greek society. We need a change of attitude in the public administration. They have to look to be a lot more effective, efficient, and be less bureaucratic in their mindset, and decide to take on responsibility rather than throw it to kick the can, as we say. It has to do with the judicial system that has to work a lot faster and a lot more efficiently. It has to do with the labor unions, the local communities, on how they understand that this is a unique and non-recurring opportunity. This opportunity will never, in the foreseeable future, be available to us. This kind of money, this kind of opportunity for reform, this kind of opportunity for digital and green transformation, for private investment, this is not going to come. So we have to take advantage of it. And to do that, we will do everything everything that we can do. We will look into the processes, we will give motives, financial and other motives. We will digitalize the whole process, we will simplify it, but also we will try, and this is important in this gathering, to mobilize as much private money as we can, because this program can only succeed if, together with the public money that we have from the RRF and the other programs, we mobilize huge amounts of private money, both to be more efficient and effective because of working together of will succeed because we don't have the luxury of failure.